Hey everybody, my name is Jonathan. Today I went spear fishing and I caught me a red snapper off of Bradenton Beach. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna clean them up and eat them.
Little slippery little guy. Yum 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 yum.
Alright, so I am using a dull instrument, butter knife if you will. Nicole doesn't know about it yet because she's getting mad at me if she knew I was using her stuff to scale this. And as you can see, the scales are kind of coming everywhere. So, kind of bend down and get somewhere where it doesn't really matter if scales are everywhere. Preferably not Nicole's kitchen. She probably wouldn't like this at all. There's some on my nose. Alright, so, even though I'm a marine biology major, I really don't know anything about fish, but I'm pretty sure this is a red snapper because red snappers are reef fish, and I was pretty much at a reef when I caught this little guy. Plus, he has this kind of characteristic spiky stuff up here and down here as well. So it's pretty characteristic. I'm pretty sure it's a red snapper just because of the way his fins are. And since these fins are pretty sharp, you might want to wear some gloves because he can still hurt you. Alright, so I'm cutting the dorsal fin off of this red snapper now. They have a mild toxin, so you don't want that in the way. So I'm just going to use kitchen shears and just cut along.
Hi, my name's Nicole and welcome back to my kitchen. As you saw earlier, my husband Jonathan, he got himself a fish today and he brought it home. Now we're not used to cooking whole fish here. I have to admit that I go down to the grocery store and I usually get a nice fillet and we cook that up. So this is going to be a new challenge for us, so we thought we'd make a video of it. He went ahead and scaled this beautiful Gulf red snapper and he cut off the dorsal fin, as we said earlier. And now I am going to use my fillet knife and we're going to try to make a couple fillets out of this beautiful red snapper. So I have about a 7-inch fillet knife here. This is one of the smaller ones, but this is plenty big enough for me. And we are going to start just around the head, and we're going to make like a semicircle here because there's really no meat up in the head area. Okay, so now we're just going to make our starting point right at the top here. Just a little incision. And laying it. So I'm going to go parallel to my cutting board and hold my hand flat down on this, and I'm just going to kind of feel and gently go, and I feel that bone down right in the middle, so I'm just going to go about halfway down, kind of gently go across all the way to the tail. Okay. There we go. As you can see, we went right to that bone right there and cut it open. Okay, so now I've gone around the tail here and we're just going to start going, kind of pulling it off of these rib and radial bones here. Be gentle, kind of like shaving. Okay. We've just about got it off. I'm just kind of shaving right here, getting it away from the bone. Now as you see, this fish is a little bloody. This is what happens when you sear fish. So it's not quite as pretty as if you were to get this at your fish market. Another benefit of getting it at the fish market is they usually scale it for you and will clean out all the guts and all the gross parts. So this looks easy, not as easy as it looks. Okay, so here is our first fillet. Not too shabby for a first time. And now you just flip the fish over and you do the same thing. So you should get at least two nice big fillets out of this red snapper. So, like we started, we're just going to cut a round circle this way. And then we're going to cut along the top and just feel for the bone, kind of shave, not really slice, and be as gentle as possible and go right along that rib bone so you can get as big and thick of a fillet as possible.
Alright, so I just cleaned these pliers and now I'm getting all these pin bones out. Nicole did a good job on this one. There's no ribs, but there are little tiny pin bones and you can feel them with your fingers and you just have to use your pliers to pull them out.
So now we're going to bake our fish fillets. So we have two large fillets, so we're going to put those in our baking dish. We've already rinsed them and gotten all the pin bones out and any scales that we missed. And then we are going to coat these with a little bit of olive oil and salt and pepper, and then put some white wine at the bottom of the pan. And then just top them with whatever you like. I'm using some lemon slices and some fresh parsley. And I'm just going to lay the lemon slices right on top. And all you do after that is put a little aluminum foil on and pop them in the oven. I have it at about 350, and you know, you can check your fish anywhere between 20 and 30 minutes. And I'm going to be cooking my jumbo sea scallops over here in my cast iron, getting a nice sear on these. These are going to go great with our fish, and then probably do some rice and some sauteed broccoli. Alright, so here we go. Here is our delicious red snapper that we've baked in the oven. Then we have some jumbo seared sea scallops, and I've made a parsley and lemon rice. And then I topped both of these with just a sauce I made, a pan sauce, with some white wine, parsley, shallots, lemon juice, and some butter. So bon appetit!